Good morning, children. Your second chapter is bringing up carry. Before taking this story in detail, let me tell you what is there in this chapter. In this chapter, there is an elephant, 5 months elephant. This elephant is brought up by the narrator, and he is very faithful. He grows in size and years together. Though he was five months old and the narrator was 9 years old, but they were still this elephant was bigger because they grow faster. And that is why they were friends, because both of them, they were baby. Narrator was 5 years old, he was a baby. And 5 months elephant was also a baby. They were brought up together. They were friends of each other. Elephant was very faithful. Once he saw that a boy was drowning in the river, he was very cautious to save that particular boy from drowning. And he also called his friend narrator for saving that particular boy. Second thing, he was very fond of small twigs also. So narrator used to get these sharp and delicate twig by working very hard. And also we are able to see that the elephant was fond of bananas. Actually, he developed interest to eat bananas. So he started stealing. But ultimately, narrator taught him a lesson that stealing is not a good thing. Though elephants, they are animals, but they understand. Like children, they understand. So by scolding itself, he came to know that I should not do it again. And the third situation, the elephant is taught how to sit down, how to move ahead, how to go fast, how to go slow, and to learn a master call. Whenever his master is in danger, he is supposed to save him, and for that purpose. Let us start what happens line by line. First of all, we'll come to know about the object of the lesson. Teaching this lesson gives some benefit to us. Some of the education we'll get after learning this lesson, after going through this lesson. There are some educational values, there are some moral values we are going to learn. So after completing the lesson, the students will be able to share their personal experiences, and they will also express themselves in grammatically correct sentences, and also they will be creating interest towards the story reading. They will also be sensitized towards relationship with animals, and also they will be made aware of new words and phrases that they will use in their language. And also there will be habit development, that is reading habit. So these are the objectives of teaching this particular chapter. After completing the chapter, we are supposed to acquire these all qualities in ourselves. Let us see further. The key points of this particular story are: the story is about a 5 months old baby elephant. One. Secondly, Carrie is not able to play with the missives. Elephant is also sensitive, is very faithful baby also, baby elephant. And is, as we are discussing, he has developed interest towards ripe bananas. Quick learner he was, though. He was 5 months and the narrator was 9 years old, and also a keeper was there, who was the trainer to this particular elephant. After that, we'll see that the elephant is taught how to walk, how to sit, how to go fast, how to go slow, and what is the meaning of master call, if a master call is given. Next, let's start. What are the brief points of this particular part? First part, there's a carry 5 months old baby elephant. After that, he leaves, grows up with a 9 years old friend and keeper. Is that is what the situation is. Afterwards, the carry doesn't eat much, but he developed interest towards many things. He used to eat 16 kilograms of delicious twigs and play and sensitive. Carry saves a baby from the drowning in the pond, in the stream. Let us see how he does. Carry, the elephant, was 5 months old when he was given to me to take care of. The narrator says that elephant was 5 months old when he was given to me, and the elephant was given to the narrator for what? For taking care of, for looking after. I was 9 years old, and the narrator was 9 years old, and I could trace his back. And what was the physical situation? That the narrator was able to reach his back, means elephant's back, if he stood on tiptoe. Tiptoe means on his toes. On his toes, if he is to stand, then he is to reach up to the top of the elephant. Now, next, he seemed to remain that high the nearly 2 years. For 2 years, constantly, he was of that height only. We grew together. That is probably why I never found just how tall he was. That we were growing together, and that is why I was not able to understand how he was growing. He lived in the pavilion. This elephant, baby elephant, used to live in a pavilion under a thatchet. Thatchet means covered with a thatch. Roof which rested on a thick tree stump on, so that it could not fall when carry bump against the poles as he moved about. Whenever the elephant used to move about, he used to bump against the poles, and that is why these poles, they were made of thick tree stumps. Let us see further what happens. This is what the place where elephant used to live, that was the pavilion. Let us see next. One of the first thing Carry did was to save the life of a boy. Now, on the part of elephant, as to give the credit to the elephant, we are able to see the first quality that the Carry showed, that he saved the life of a boy. Carry did not eat much, but he nevertheless needed 40 pounds of twigs a day. He chew, play with. Every day I used to take, a lot of time to collect these twigs and all. That is what the narrator says. Every day he used to take this elephant in the morning for his bath. And one more thing which was there, that every day he used to take that elephant for the bath. He would lie down on the sand bank while I rubbed him clean sand on the river of an hour. For an hour he used to rub that clean sand and used to enjoy. After that, he would lie on the water long time. For a long time, he used to lie down in the water, on which he used to enjoy. In which he used to enjoy for a long time. On coming out of his skin would be shining like a morning. Now, when he used to come out of that water, his skin used to shine like a ebony. Now, ebony is what? Ebony is a kind of black hardwood. So in it is the comparison made between his skin and the bony. And he would squeal with pleasure as I rubbed when down his back. Whenever I used to rub that water down, he used to squeal. Next, this is the elephant, and I used to reach his back if I used to stand on my tiptoe. That is what the thing is. Next, then I would take him by the ear. After the bath, I used to take him back by the ear. I used to catch his ear and I used to take back home, because that is the easiest way to lead an elephant, because that is only the way to lead an elephant. And I leave him on the edge of the jungle while I went into the forest to get some delicious twigs for his dinner. And for getting some delicious, delicate twigs for his dinner, I used to leave him at the edge of the jungle. And after that, one has to have a very sharp hatchet to cut down these twigs. It used to take a lot of time to cut down these twigs, because it takes half an hour to sharpen the hatchet. Also, because if a twig is mutilated, an elephant will not touch it. First thing, it used to take a lot of time to sharpen a hatchet. Secondly, if a twig is mutilated, the elephant did not eat it. And that is why it used to be very, very cautious work for me. Next, it was not an easy job to get twigs and saplings for carrying. That is why we can say, we can conclude that it was not easy job to get saplings for carrying. I had to climb all kinds of trees to get the most delicate and tender twigs. The narrator says that he used to climb many kinds of trees to get the delicate and tender twigs. That is what he used to eat. As he was very, very fond of young branches of a banyan tree, which grows like a cathedral. Now, he was very fond of the branches of cathedral. The cathedral is like a high ceiling plant, that is what. And for leaves and branches, he was very fond of those twigs. I was gathering some one spring day in the March. In March, there was an incident that I was gathering some twigs for Carrie, when I suddenly heard Carrie calling me in the distance. I heard that Carrie was calling me in the distance. As he was still very young, the call was more like that of a baby than an elephant. And the call was just like a baby, not like an elephant. I thought somebody was hurting him. And while listening to this particular voice, I concluded that somebody was hurting my elephant. So I came down from my tree, and that is why I came down from my tree and ran fast, very fast, to the edge of the forest where I had left him. But he was not there. And I came down from the tree and went to the direction where I left the elephant. I did not find the elephant there. Where has the elephant gone? Let us see. I looked all over, but I could not find him. I looked everywhere. The elephant was not there. I went near the edge of the water. I went near the edge of the water, and I saw a black something struggling above the surface. Then I saw towards the water. I saw something black was struggling above the surface. Then it rose higher, and it took that it was a trunk of my elephant. I could recognize that it was an elephant's trunk, and it must be my elephant. I thought he was droning, and by seeing the trunk, I think my elephant was droning. I was helpless, but another part I was helpless, because I could not jump into the water and save the 400 pounds of him since he was much higher than I. Because the elephant was much higher than I could not save that elephant who weighed 400 pounds. And that is why it was a risk. But I saw his back rise above the water. But when I saw that his back was rising above the water, and the moment he caught my eye, the moment the elephant caught my eye, he began to trumpet, squeal, and struggle up the shore. And then he was struggling up the shore, coming toward the shore. Then, still trumpeting, he pushed me into the water. And as I fell into the stream, I saw a boy lying flat on the bottom of the river. Came to the shore, and then he pushed me into the water. When I went into the stream, I found that there was a boy lying flat on the bottom of the river. He had altogether touched bottom. No, he did not touch the bottom. He had not altogether touched the bottom, but somewhat afloat, somewhat above the bottom. I came to the surface to the water to take my breath. Then what I did, I came to the surface of the water to take my breath, and there Carrie was standing. I saw that Carrie was standing, his feet planted in the sand bank. And in what position? His feet was planted in the sand bank. And his trunk stretched out like a hand. And then his trunk was extending towards me, just like he was like a hand just waiting for me. Just as if a hand was waiting for me, his trunk was stretched in that fashion. And thus, I dived down again and pulled the body of the drowning boy to the surface. But not being a good swimmer, I could not swim ashore. I could not come back to the shore, and slow current was already dragging me. And that slow current was already dragging me down. I was not able to come back because I was not a good swimmer. Seeing us drift by the current, Carrie, when he saw that we were drifting back into the current, who was usually slow and ponderous, suddenly darted down. Darted down means it rushed down. Suddenly rushed down to us like a hawk, and came halfway into the water where I saw him stretched out his trunk. And then I saw the elephant stretched out his trunk again. I raised up my hand to catch it. And it slipped. What happens next? I found myself going under the water again, and then I found myself that I was going again under the water. But this time, I found that the water was not very deep. So I sank to the bottom, to the river, and doubled my feet under me, and then suddenly kicked the river bed, and so shot upwards like an arrow. And I just shot myself upwards, just like an arrow, in spite of the fact that I was holding the drowning boy. He was also holding the drowning boy with my hand. The narrator said that with my hand, I was holding the drowning boy. As my body rose above the water, I felt a lasso around my neck. When I was coming out of the particular water, I felt there was a kind of lasso around my neck. And the moment I felt there was a lasso around my neck, this frightened me. I got afraid of it. I thought some water animal was going to swallow me. The first idea came to my mind was that some water animal is there that is going to swallow me. I heard Carrie squealing. But when I heard Carrie squealing, I knew it was his trunk about my neck. Then I could find out that it was his trunk, and he pulled us both ashore. And then, next part, what happens? Carry becomes fond of ripe bananas. He believes on self-help, much to the discomfort of his friend. With quite a dignity, Carry accepts the chiding he knows he deserves. In the next part, what he does, he steals bananas, and after getting scolding from his master, he learns a lesson that I should not do these things. Let us see what happens in this part. Carry was like a baby. He had to be trained to be good, and if he did not tell him when he was naughty, he was up to more mischief than ever. He was like a baby, and whenever he is not pointed out for his mistakes, he used to be more naughty and mischievous. For instance, one day somebody gave him some banana to eat. There was a situation where somebody gave him a banana to eat. Very soon he developed a great love for ripe banana, and he started developing interest in eating bananas because they were so tasty for him. We used to keep large plates of fruits on the table near a window in the dining room. In the dining room, they used to keep a large plate full of fruits. One day, all the bananas on the table disappeared, and my family blamed the servant for eating all the fruits in the house. One day, the bananas were missing. What my family members did, they blamed that the servant has taken all the bananas. A few days later, the fruit disappeared again. After a few days, same thing happened. The fruit disappeared again. This time, the blame was put on me. This time, I was there to be blamed. I knew I had not done it. And I was sure that I had not done it. It made me very angry. It made me very angry for what? For blaming with my parents and the servant. For I was sure they had taken all the fruit. The next time the fruit disappeared. Next time also fruit disappeared. I found a banana all smashed up in the Carry's pavilion. I found that bananas were smashed in Carry's pavilion. This surprised me very much. And I found that banana smashed up in the Carry's pavilion. That surprised me very much. For I had never seen fruit there. And as you know, he had always lived on twigs. That elephant, he had already lived on twigs. And he never ate banana. No, never hoped for that. Let us see what happens next. This is what the fruit basket, and this is how the trunk used to come and carry all the fruits. Let us see next. Next day, when I was sitting in the dining room, wondering whether I should take up a fruit from the table without my parents' permission, a long black thing, very much like a snake, suddenly came through the window and disappeared with all the bananas. When next day what happens, I found that just like a black snake, there was a thing appeared through the window and disappeared with all bananas. I was very much frightened. Then seeing this, I was very, very afraid because I had never seen snakes eat bananas. I thought that that was snake, and snakes never eat bananas. I was very afraid, and I thought it must be a terrible snake. Then I considered it must be a terrible snake which must be eating bananas and all, that would sneak in and take fruit. Then I thought that I think this is a terrible snake which used to take the bananas. I crept out of the room. Then I went out of the room with great fear in my heart, ran out of the house, And then I ran out of the house, feeling sure that the snake would come back into the house. Then I was sure that snake will definitely come back to the house, eat all the fruit and kill all of us. And that is the danger, that if we don't find out where the snake is, how he eats, how he goes back, then again it will be coming, and sometimes it will attack the family members also. Let us see. As I went out, I saw Carrie's bag disappearing in the direction of the pavilion. When I went out, I saw Carrie's bag was disappearing in the direction of the pavilion, and I was so frightened that I wanted his company to cheer me up. I was always frightened. I was frightened with the thinking about the terrible snake. I wanted his company, and he was disappearing in the direction of the pavilion. That I wanted his company to cheer me up, I ran after him into the pavilion, and I found him there eating bananas. You know, when I reached there, I found that my Carrie was eating bananas. I stood still in this astonishment. Astonishment means surprised. I was surprised. The bananas were lying strewn all around him. And those bananas were lying strewn all around. He stretched out his trunk and reached for one far away from where he was standing. When he went into the pavilion, he stretched his trunk for one banana. I found out that yes, it is eating. That was sure for me that he was only the creature eating bananas from the house. Now the thief was caught. Who is the thief, children? The elephant was the thief for those bananas. So this is how the narrator caught his own Carrie eating bananas. The blame was put on sometime narrator or sometime the servants. So the mystery was revealed. Let us see what. That instant the trunk looked like a black snake. And at that time I felt that the trunk was looking like a black snake. I realized that Carrie was the thief. And I was sure that Carrie was the thief. I went to him, pulled him out by the ear, and joyously showed my parents that it was Carrie and not I that had eaten all the fruit these many weeks. These many weeks, this was only the creature who was eating these fruits and not I. Then I scolded him. Then I scolded him, snapped him. For elephants understand words as well as children. As children understand words, elephants also understand these words. And I said to him, next time I see you stealing fruit, you will be whipped. You'll be punished like anything. He knew that we were all angry with him. By listening this, he knew that we all were angry with him. Even the servant, his pride was so injured, and now his pride was so injured when he was caught. He never stole another thing from the dining room, and thereafter the elephant never stole anything from the dining room. And from then on, and from that day only, if anybody gave him any fruit, that was the great change on that particular elephant. Whenever somebody was giving him any fruit, he always squealed as to thank them. Whenever somebody used to give him fruit, he used to squeal for thanking. An elephant is willing to be punished for having done wrong, because it's in the elephant's nature that he is willing to be punished if he has done something wrong. But if you punish him without reason, if you punish an elephant without reason, he will remember it. He will remember it, and pay you back in your own coin. As you are punished, in the same way he is going to punish you. Next. Brief notes is like this for the third part is, Gary is fast learner. He masters all signals, sounds. He is taught. Now there is one lesson, though that an elephant takes 5 years to learn, Gary is no exception. That lesson is master call. Let us see how he learns. An elephant must be taught when to sit down, when to walk, when to go fast, when to go slow, and like this, the elephant has to be taught. You teach him these things as you teach a child, and these all things are taught to the elephant just like a child. If you say Dhat and pull him by the ear, if it's word Dhat and pull him by the ear, he will gradually learn to sit down. There is only one indication that a coal like Dhat is given and is pulled by the ear, the elephant will learn how to sit down. Similarly, if you say Mali, if you say Mali and pull his trunk, he will gradually learn that that it is the signal to walk. It is the signal to walk. And this is how he is taught. He's a good learner also. He learned these old things very speedily. How? Gary learned Mali in 3 lessons only. Mali means what? That's Mali means, say Mali and pull his trunk means he will understand that it is the signal to walk. So he learned this signal in 3 lessons only. But it took him 3 weeks to learn Dhat. But this Dhat, it took 3 weeks. He was good at sitting down. He was no good at sitting down. No, because that why he took 3 weeks, because he was not good at sitting down. That is why he took a lot of time. Do you know how the elephants would be taught to sit down? Are you sure? Do you know how an elephant should be taught how to sit down? Because he grows taller and taller, and it takes him for a lot of time to reach to his back. Is that in the earlier also we have discussed that the narrator used to reach his back after raising himself on his toes. So it is necessary to teach him sitting down, because it is good that we teach him sitting down. Then only we can reach up to his top, otherwise not. See, because he grows taller and taller than you. Because whatever the height we have, it grows taller and taller, taller and taller. We cannot reach up to his back. So that is why we are supposed to teach him how to sit down. Take care of him so that when he is 2 or 3 years old, you can only reach his back with a ladder. Because after 2 or 3 years, we can reach up to his back using a ladder. It is therefore better to teach him to sit down by saying Dhat, so that you can climb upon his back. And that is what the reason we are supposed to teach him to sit down. For who would want to carry a ladder around all the time? Because we cannot carry ladder all the time, and that is why it is necessary. Next. The most difficult thing to teach an elephant is the master call. The third thing which we are supposed to teach him is the master call. He generally takes 5 years to learn it. 5 years, how many? 5 years, because it is very difficult for him to learn properly. A master call, now we are supposed to understand what is master call. A master call is a strange hissing, howling sound as if a snake or a tiger were fighting each other. So this type of sound, if it is created, that is master call. And if you have to make that kind of noise in his ear, and if that kind of noise is made in his ear, the tiger, this elephant will understand. Do you know what you expect the elephant to do when this call is given, the master call is given? If you are lost in the jungle, there is no way out and everything is black except the stars above. Only stars are there, everything is black. You dare not stay very long there. You want to get out of that particular situation, and that is why it is necessary to give a master call at once to the elephant. Will do what? Will start pulling down the trees in front of him and will with his trunk and frighten all the animals away. Whatever the animals, dangerous animals are there in that particular jungle where you are stuck, they will run away because of this particular strange arrangement by the elephant. He will start pulling down the trees, and those trees will make a lot of noise, and all the dangerous animals will run away. This is how this master calls helps. As three comes crashing down, monkeys made from their sleep and run from the branches to branch, and you can see when tree comes down, crashing down, what happens? Monkeys, they will get out, they will make this scale, they will wake up from their sleep, they will run from branch to branch. You can also see what? You can also see them in moonlight, and you can also see the stags running all directions below. Now you can also find the stags, they were running in the all directions away from that particular noise where the noise is created because of the falling trees. You can hear the growl of, and also you can hear the growl of a tiger in the distance. Now even he is frightened, the tiger also frightened. Then the elephant pulls down the next tree, and in this way elephant keeps on doing his work, next tree and then next and then next. Like this, he will keep on doing these all things, and all the dangerous animals will run away, and thus you are saved from that particular jungle lake situation. Okay, now what happens? Soon you will find that the problem is over. He has made a road right through the jungle straight to your house, and this is how the master call is very, very important. So this is what the chapter is. Now let us see the question answers. The enclosure in which Carrie lived had a thatched roof that lay on thick tree stumps. Now you have to illustrate this particular situation mentioned on your textbook page number 8, and tell how it is built like this. So it is built like this because whenever Carrie used to move inside that particular pavilion, he used to bump against the poles. Those poles, the roof, thatched roof, should not fall down, and that is why it was made like that. The enclosure was made like this. Let us see. Did Carrie enjoy his morning bath in the river? Yes, Carrie enjoyed the morning bath in the river. How can we say that? He used to squeal and used to lie down in the water for a long time. Finding good twigs for Carrie took a long time. Why? Finding good twigs for Carrie took a long time because it required a lot of time to sharpen the hatch, and also finding delicate twigs is another important work which took a lot of time. Because if the twig is mutilated, then the elephant is not going to eat them. Why did Carrie push his friend into the stream? Why did Carrie push his friend into the stream? Carrie pushed his friend into the stream to save the drowning child. Let us see next. Carrie was like a baby. what are the main points of comparison? He used to grow with the narrator. First, secondly, used to make the sound like a baby, not like an elephant. He was very childish. When we see that he used to jump to save the giant, the drowning boy. Carrie helped him to all the bananas. Carrie helped himself to all the bananas in the house without anyone's noticing it. How did he do it? He used to do it through window. Through the window, he used to sneak in and take away all the fruits from the table with the help of his trunk. Carrie learned the command to sit down and walk. What were the instructions for each command? When you say that and pull by the ear, it is the signal to sit down. And when you say Mali and pull his trunk, it is the signal to walk. And this is how he was taught. What is a master call? Master call is a strange hissing sound, as if a tiger and snake, they are fighting. This type of sound, if it is made in his ear, then the elephant will learn that a signal is given, his master is in danger. He will start pulling down the trees and will make the way for his house, and thus the narrator will be his master will be saved. And this is how the topic ends. Thank you.